In the year 1300s, when your first white slave came here from Slovakia, or they called them Slovaks or Slavs or slaves. So that's when white people first came to America. So when you're reading documents about slaves, like pre-colonial up to about 1776, slaves were white people, and Negroes were Irish and German people. So those were not you that you were reading about. You were the we the people in order to form a more perfect union.
In 1492, you came up on these shores, 700 years educated by the Moors. 17th century, genocide and the gun. Middle Passage blessed to market the Africans in the so-called lands of God. My kind were treated hard. From back then until now, I see and you agree, we have been a misrepresented people. From back then until now, just see my family tree, we have been a misrepresented people. We have been a misrepresented people.
Once we're back with Changing the Lens, and now we're sitting here with Fatisha Hutchins, also, of course, from our beautiful city of Newark. And Fatisha, so why don't you tell us a little bit about yourself and who you are?
Okay. First, I would like to say thank you very much for reaching out to me to interview me. I'm a little nervous, but, you know, this is my second interview. The first one was one who was Hanifa Sharif. She was interviewing me around the time of Omar's passing.
Okay.
So that was like my first like in-depth conversation. Right. So you coming at this point in my life is very significant, because I can look at this as opposed to where I was back then, right, speaking about what I felt that my calling was.
Absolutely, absolutely. So definitely, I know that you're a person who loves your community. Mm-hmm. You love helping kids. Mm-hmm. And you've always been an upstanding role model in our community with fashion, hair, creating jobs. And, you know, instead of just following norms, you always set trends. So that went into the motivation for me. Oh, yes, honey. I'm very watchful. I'm very watchful. So that went into me, you know, wanting to interview you. Of course, this is for the youth, and I want to make sure that they have been introduced to people in our community who came up in the city of Newark, who, you know, against all odds, basically, we still were able to make it happen, because sometimes it's hard for young people, and they don't see themselves in the grand scheme of things.
Right.
So, you know, where did you grow up at, by the way?
I always tell this story. I'm from Newark, New Jersey. Born here, but I was raised in East Orange as well.
Right.
So I have two sides to who I am. Newark is where I received my education, but East Orange is where I did a lot of my athletic and recreational things. So.
And what schools did you attend in Newark?
Arts High.
Okay.
I went to Arts High.
Arts
from the Royal Avenue School.
So you sing, dance, act?
Yeah.
You want to say a little something? You
want to
say a little something?
No,
sure,
you
can
out here.
Maybe at the end.
Maybe
at the end. Okay.
Right,
we'll hold her to
that. I do a little karaoke every now and again.
A little bit. Okay.
But that was honestly something that I should have pursued.
Right.
But being young,
I saw you to a challenge.
Yeah,
on social media once.
Yeah.
And all of these years, I never knew that you could sing.
But you know what? I'm surrounded by talented people. All of my friends are very talented. I'm actually the production assistant on China Black's Keep Your Word video.
Okay.
So she won the Grammy Amplified contest. It's sponsored by Hyundai from the Grammy Academy. So we shoot the video next Monday on the 10th.
Fantastic.
So yeah, so she's doing that, and we have actually a year tour with her. And I mean, I've been around, you know, dealing with her and her career, but I would never just sing behind the
right. Oh, they get me in the church pew. Now, I don't go to church. I don't go to church. But I'm very, very spiritual. But I do funerals.
Okay. By request, because
My best friend is Joshua Nelson. Okay. He is an organist. He does the Mahalia thing.
Oh, singing. Okay. Gotcha.
And then we just put on performances.
Right.
So it actually started at my son's funeral, where we all come together as high school students, and we perform for each other during those times and losses. Right. So our time, school has done more for me in my adult life, too, not just, you know, the education. It built the bond of friendships.
Yeah.
Savion Glover, my son, Brother Haas, he's has a movement now. So we all support each other.
Absolutely.
We did a cruise.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm, the four of us together. And nice. Next year we'll do something really spectacular for our 25th anniversary.
Nice. So tell us a little bit about your pathway from, you know, being in Newark, growing up in Newark, to becoming the successful entrepreneur that you are now.
To be honest with you, it's almost like I'm living in a euphoria. I'm in a place where life is coming together and it's making sense.
Right.
So my choices, my decisions, my experiences, my weaknesses, my strengths, and leading to a calling. And my calling was always helping people. So along my path, God has always sent me people to come tell me vision, dreams, different things like that. And I just had to hold on to it. So one of them was that my name would be associated with a foundation that would be known around the world.
Oh, and what's the name of the foundation?
Well, I didn't know.
At the time, when I first came to you.
This was like 7 years ago. I talk about this all the time. You know me, I'm always saying, I'm like the Twilight Zone. Like, like what she got going on now in her head? But, surprisingly, back then it happened, but life happened and it took me on this road to be able to receive my blessing and then put me in a position to kind of like be baby Oprah in a way. Like, I was like, baby, what you need?
Yeah.
I got it. What you need? I got it. Yeah. So, even though we were all sitting here talking, I have a lot of solutions that you were all talking about, and I'm looking for passionate people that have causes that I can link to these charities and these philanthropists and these.
How did you get started with this?
I have no clue. My son passed away. I can say that.
Oh, I'm sorry.
And I went.
What happened with your son?
My son passed away from leukemia. It was very sudden, like less than 6 or 7 months. So that's what started the purging. And after that, I had to stop and listen. And everything just changed. So the more you pay attention to the inner you, God hears you.
And I hear you, you know, you speak of your son and you become upset and you know, and I know Omar, he's a great kid. And you know, I think like now, you know, in the city of Newark, we have so many young people just senselessly destroying their lives, you know, and he had no choice in that. What is there anything that you would like to say to young people that does that don't find, you know, that I don't know if they value life?
What I can say is that being raised and having circumstances, you're actually learning. Even at this age, sitting here, there are so many things that I did not know that I wasn't even willing to sacrifice at some times.
Sacrifice.
Only because I had to do everything.
Right.
So I had to be a mother. I had to, you know, run a business.
And
I
so many women
I had to do the run to the school, to drop off, the pickups. And now today, being suffocated and having help, like people that stepped up and said, I got you.
And that's so important. Listen, we're going to stop that right here for a moment.
Yeah,
we'll be right back with Changing the Lens.
Thank you.
I can't. So, with your acting, are you doing anything with that still, or have you like changed what you're doing in terms of that?
Well, okay. Basically, what happened? I met a gentleman named Hope of Hollywood.
Hope of Hollywood.
Hope of Hollywood. Okay. I was actually at the FIMA, F-I-M-A, at the African Union at the United Nations, and he was doing some video. Oh yeah, yeah.
Nice.
So yeah, that's awesome. That's they have some great initiatives for designers and manufacturing for to bring a connection between the Africa and the artists and designers here in the United States.
Because fantastic.
Yeah, you know, it's not fair on the runway over there.
Right,
so,
right.
So these are kings and queens and heads of state. Actually, one of the richest women in the world. The one that's rich and Oprah now. She's on the committee. So it's a lot going on there. So anyway, I was there and I met this gentleman and I did an interview. He went home and his mom said, call her back, I need her. So I'm like, so he asked me, so I took an acting class, so that's what you're referring to.
Okay.
But acting isn't for me, but I do have some projects coming down the line that I can't speak about. Okay. But in that event, I have, I'm a chief art marketing officer for BTTN. It's an IPTV television station. So actually I'm doing more executive producing now. So I produced quite a few shows, and I'm working with Tammy Lamore, here in Newark as well. So I don't know if you interview her.
Yeah, not yet, but
okay, well, that's one of my business partners. So we're doing some things in Atlanta and here.
Nice.
So actually, I'll be developing shows for about 1,000 channels. We can talk about it and give you a platform, and you know, people can go on Roku and find your show.
Excellent. Sounds excellent.
Yeah,
thank you so much.
Yeah, you deserve it. We got to get those on the grits. And you know what
else?
I was talking to the guy at the NAACP, so we're going to have a lot of the National African American Journalism Society taking some looks at Newark too and reaching out to some positive
absolutely
guests and hosts and
absolutely
shows. And
fantastic.
So it's a lot happening. So when that happens, I'll come back to you directly.
Excellent. Sounds like a go.
Yeah.
And you know what? Collaborating and working together is exactly what we need to change
movement.
The
movement. It's a movement. So we need more of us.
Definitely. And we're on the path.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Changing the lens.
So now when you read the news and you see this going on, you sitting up there mad as hell. And it ain't even supposed to be happening to you. You know what I mean?
Right.
Like, I can't. Like, my people.
No, we're gonna lose a lot.
Oh my god. Listen, we haven't lost anything. We're actually gaining everything back. But you just have to be in position
to be
able. First of all, everybody missed the first reset. There will be a reset. So some people will get $1 billion when the reset happens. That list is gone. You know what I'm saying? And if I don't know what to say, then 7 years. The rest of us, you know, will get the rest of, you know, like what's left, but you'll still get your billion. But this is all of these corporations that made money off of our birth certificates.
Mm-hmm.
What they did was illegal.
Mm-hmm.
So now when you're looking at these large global corporations with trillions of dollars, now you look at, you say, okay, Bill Gates made this year. I'm just not gonna say Bill Gates is like, you know,
right.
What he has is connected to slavery or anything.
Right.
But what I'm saying is, what did they make the year before that and the year before that and the year before that? Like, how you have all of that money and that's based off of you trading my social security number on the stock market. You know what I mean? But here it is. I have to pay taxes. I have to pay for
everything.
I have to pay to die.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
For everything.
And we're taxed. And, you know, thank God Obama gave back the land rights to indigenous people. So at least now we have an opportunity to go back. And for those of us who believe that we those of us who say we have Indian in our family, that's like just saying I am Indian. You know what I mean? So, you know, you have a chance to go back, and then if you don't know where you came from, just do a blood test. More than likely, you're native, meaning native to this land, and you know,
I am Isabel, the owner of Closet Savvy Consignment. I am so excited to have a consignment boutique, a high-end designer consignment boutique, downtown Newark. I was born and raised here. My 3 college credits I got right here. You know, I'm just excited about about Newark and all that's going on.
It's all about taking old things and making them new again, or just repurposing things. And we like to bring that element into the design of the store. Like, we love to repurpose this amazing bench. And it's going to be so amazing that I'm sure my kids may want to use it in their place. And it'll really get a lot of use. Don't look like much now, but it's going to be fabulous.
So what about this chair?
The chair is also a thrift piece. I think I paid $3 for it, and I think I want to do it a hot pink, you know?
Just
make
great.
It stand out, and then throw a really cool, colorful pillow on it, and it'll be a standout piece. Repurpose it.
Awesome. So how long have you been down here in the city of Newark?
I've been in Newark about 60 days, and I have to say it's been amazing. The city of Newark, the residents, the business owners in the neighborhood have all been very welcoming. The residents
love me. How did you become an entrepreneur?
The business actually started when my oldest daughter was preparing for college, and I realized that I wasn't prepared. So I said to her that she and I would start a business together. She's the majority owner and truly the boss of me. So we started this business. I took all of the bags out of my closet and said that we would start a business to fund her college. She went to an all-girls boarding school in Massachusetts, and she's now at Barnard, the women's college at Columbia. And it was no other place for us to go but to Newark to start a business. And we're here. It's been 2 years. We got through her first year of college with no loans.
Dynamite.
All from Closet Savvy. And we're hoping to get
it.
We all have our
talent.
And I think that the second we find it and we find confidence in ourselves, you know, we're prepared to go out and to do our own thing. I think stick with your dream, keep doing it. It's amazing working for yourself. No one else is gonna be a better boss than you, and you could do it. We all did it. I came here, grew up in the inner city, single parent, you know, situation, in the worst situation as anyone else. We can do it. It's being done right now.
Izzy, are you from Newark?
I am.
What part?
My mama moved around a lot, so we grew up everywhere. Avon Avenue, Hawthorne Avenue, Clinton Avenue. All over Newark we lived. I actually went to Avon Avenue School, University.
Nice.
High. I went to Shabazz for a few years. Jersey Prep.
Jersey Prep.
Jersey Prep. The thing was only open a few years.
I don't even know
if it was really an accredited school. I don't know how much research my mother did, but they did issue me a diploma.
Right. Awesome. Awesome. So what do you see Newark going in the next several years?
I see Newark being like Hoboken in the next few years. There's going to be a lot of swanky boutiques down here. There are a lot of amazing people coming into Newark. There's a lot of great restaurants and clubs opening up. It's really, even now, you can kind of walk around the city and there's entertainment and culture. In 6 years, it's going to be insane. I'm so happy to be here right now.
Excellent, excellent. And my last question, what advice would you give to young people who are living in the city, but not making the best choices right now and doing things to get themselves in trouble? What kind of advice would you give to those youngsters so that they can also be a part of this great transformation that's happening here in the city?
I think that I would advise them to look past today. You know, whatever it is that we're going through today is today's situation, and we want better for tomorrow. One day we're going to be a mother or father, and we're going to want our children to do the right thing. You know, today is a very temporary state. We all want to do well. We all can do well. It's being proven. We can do it. That's the message. You can do it.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Izzy.
Thank you. The most enjoyable part of my job. It started off online, and that was cool, you know, but getting into the store and interacting with women and realizing how insecure we all are about something, how damaged we are, how a compliment given really can change someone's perspective. Like, I have women come in, complete strangers, and we talk, we hug, we cry, and it's just a positive experience. I always leave feeling inspired and encouraged, and they do too. And that's what it's about. We're all suffering through something, and we have to have a little bit more compassion for one another. That's it. I'm not your competition. I'm your sister. That's it.
Mm-hmm. I'm the interior decorator that Isabel confidently brought in to design her space for her. She told me she wanted it over the top and amazing, and that's what I did. Most people love it. I hope you do too. Come check it out.
From here, the theme was
industrial glam for the boutique.
Okay.
And we tried to really accomplish that and really like show off Isabel's personality in the space, show off how original she is. Like if you think about the shorts, the distressed Levi shorts and all of that, put you in the mindset of all of that, plus the fabulous pieces and things that she finds. We hand built that rack right there that you're focused on. Those are columns that we found in Newark. And we hand, we had the artist hand build those, that rack, and create like a rolling rack out of it. Same thing with those vintage doors. Those doors are hand painted. Those are 100-year-old antique doors right there that we created as racks. Those are from Newark. They came out of a building that was being torn down, and we used those as door racks. So we brought in a lot of the spirit of the city. And right now it's like kind of messy, but you guys gotta come back and see it. Hand when it's through the artist spray painted the light fixtures. And I actually strung 180 crystals on all of those. I brought in an artist that came in and did those paintings on the wall, fashion, spade, style is eternal. And this, the same local Newark artist built those racks, did the artwork, and worked hand in hand with me to make this place look amazing.
And amazing it is.
And, you know, I'm sorry that the bubble chair is down right now, but it'll be up soon. And we did the cement wall in the back full of shoes. There's another antique mirror, that floor ceiling mirror that we did. And this is also the artist hand painted this mannequin. Nice. It says love and lust on it. It's a graffiti. He did that for me for the store. And even the piece that she's standing on. So this antique piece right here, this curio piece, is an original antique piece that was owned by the mayor of Verona. And I was able to find this piece in my journey of discovery for the design of this boutique and bring it into the boutique. And I thought it really fit well. I think it looks amazing in the space. It works well with Isabel's personality, and it works well with the vintage industrial glam theme. So I hope you guys love it. It's a true antique, and it's very valuable. And she can pass this on, so I'm proud to introduce you to the Beyonce. Just like the Beyonce, she's fabulous. This is a 100-year-old or more door that came out of one of the buildings right down here in Newark. It's an amazing distressed weathered door that is solid wood, and it just looks amazing. And what I had was this sconce, which is a light fixture, mirror light fixture, and we didn't know what to do with it. It was like at the end, it was like, we gotta use this somewhere. And I was sitting in the bubble chair, a light bulb went off, and I'm like, wait, let's create a door lamp. And so now that's how the Deontay was born. So everybody meet the Deontay. Deontay meet everybody. I hope you guys love it. Isabel absolutely loves it. She told me she wants me to make her some for her own house. So hopefully it's something that people will really enjoy. It's been done before. You know, I'm not, you know, claiming to be the first to create something like this, but it is original to this space. So I'm really honored to be acknowledged as an artist in Newark, working in Newark because of this boutique, because it has brought me in. But it's amazing to me to see that people really see interior decorators as artists or as part of the artist community, because it is a very creative process for us to put together a concept and a theme for a space and actually bring it into fruition. It's not an easy thing to do. And then the thing that's most challenging is not just, you know, observing and seeing what's best for the space, but also taking into consideration your client and what it is, what their spirit is about, what their goal is, what's the purpose for the space. So it's about functionality, it's about aesthetics, and it's about beauty and people who come in getting a sense of that energy when they walk into that space. So I'm really honored to be a part of the changes that are going on in Newark, and I hope to do more stuff. Any creative person or young person that is interested in making a change in Newark or making a change in their lives, my recommendation would be tapping into that power and that joy that's beyond you, because we all feel it. Like when you're pursuing your passion, you know the difference between just having a job and pursuing your passion. And I urge everyone to really find that thing that moves them, that thing that inspires them to be better and greater, and that thing that allows them to impart that same motivation and inspiration onto others. Your gift is something you cannot take for granted, and you need to share that. And not only share it, but urge others to do the same with their talents.
Oh my God, that hair looks amazing. I love it. That was a good call with the neon pink.
It's closet savvy.
Definitely.
Closet savvy.
What is it, Izzy? What is it?
Closet savvy.
Everything we do is amazing. Over the top.
My bench is going to be silver. It's going to be dope. Wait till you guys see it.
Awesome.
I feel very proud of myself right now.
And you should.
We have been numbness representing people. Yes, we have been numbness representing competition. I'm your sister. That's it.
Mm-hmm. Powerful.
Nice. I love that.